I'm not following the debates now. I'm not following the drama unfolding every day, no. I'm just looking at it from a distance and looking at it from a global perspective. And I differ with those who would consider Trump to be just another Zionist like Hillary. And the two sides of the same coin, no difference between the two. No, I differ with that. I believe that Trump offers a challenge to the system, a challenge to the political system, and the demonization of Trump that is taking place every day in the media is similar to the demonization of Russia that is taking place every day in the media. Yeah. Trump is not a Muslim. I don't expect Trump to follow the standards of Islam, no. But I expect Trump to do whatever he has to do to win the election. Even if he has to shake hands with the devil to win the elections, he would do it. Yeah, I don't see anything. I don't see anything different from that when it comes to Trump. No, but he is challenging the system. That's definitely. He is not the normal politician, no. And those in the past who have challenged the system have paid the price for it. Kennedy did that, and Kennedy is no more, okay? And I therefore have come to the conclusion that Trump poses a significant and a serious problem for them. Gog and Magog, that they cannot risk his becoming president of the United States and then blocking and stopping the war against Russia. And therefore, my interest in the subject now, from the viewpoint of eschatology, is that as the date of the American elections draw closer, and the rivalry between Trump and Clinton shows that Trump is on the ascendancy with the possibility to become president, that the dangers of the nuclear war increases, the war on Russia increasing. And I'm sure that the Russian leadership are aware of it. They don't need to be reminded by me, of course. So the world is on the brink of the Great War. And look at the American election, therefore, carefully from that perspective.